This is the Reprap Smart LCD. It's a discount version. It comes with a SD card, drive, and then of course two connectors here. It also comes with a converter stick so that you can attach it to your ramps 1.4. So to do this, you're going to attach to auxiliary 4 and auxiliary 3. Auxiliary 3 has spy pins in it, which will allow it to communicate. So to do that, you just slide it on the pins and push it down. And that's all there is to it. Now to connect this, what you do is flip this over. It's easiest if you do it like this. Now these are notched, so you're going to connect into the notch. On this side, you can see the red strip. Now it's also notched over here. So you're going to put that in there. And the second one, you're going to place in here. And you're going to put the notch like so. And that's all you have to do to connect it. Now the next step is to actually set it up and program it, but one of the things we can do to check to make sure we've connected it correctly is plug in the USB for the ramps. And if this doesn't power, it means that you've got the connectors backwards. So you just go like this. And it's correct. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to show you how to set up the Marlin firmware so that you can load it.
Okay, inside the Marlin folder for the LCD, we're going to open up the solution file. We're going to go over to the configuration tab. We're going to check under tools to make sure that we're connected to the right port. Looks like we're good there. And we're going to do a search on LCD and SD support. So we're going to scroll down and we're going to read through this real quick. Here we have a section for languages. The first one's English. And then there's a list of other languages that you can possibly choose. Some of the ones that I can highlight for you are, you've got Sprechen Sie Deutsch, got Hablo Español, got Parlez-vous Français, you got Falo Portuguesa, got Poruska, and then you have Mowage Populiska. So we're going to use English in this case. Now there's other specialized settings that you can select, but we're going to ignore most of them for the moment. So the first thing that we've come across is SD support. Now this has an SD card that we can place in the back. So we're going to uncomment that. We're going to ignore these settings for the moment. We're going to ignore the SD check and retry if you have problems with your SD card. Then you can try that. This is the speed at which you move through the menu. This is another setting that we're going to ignore for the moment, the reverse encoder direction. Reverse menu direction we're also going to ignore. The individual access homing menu, at the moment we don't need it, but you can set it up in your own free time. Now we're going to need the speaker for other videos, so we're going to uncomment that, and the speaker is on the smart LCD controller. And let's see. Now we're getting in different types of LCDs. Most of these are ones we're not currently going to use, but there's directions for how to set them up with web links. But we're looking for this one, being the Define Reprap Discount Smart Controller. We're going to uncomment that. And that's about all we're going to set up for the moment. I'll compile it in just a second. So we're going to compile and upload.
A couple of landmarks on here. You have your LCD screen. You then have your info screen, your prepare screen, your control screen, and your SD card screen. You also have your speaker over here, and of course your dial to adjust you through the menus. Now the way that you adjust is you move to where you want to be, you push down, and it takes you to where you want to go. So when you're actually finished installing, you're going to remove this, and that's going to allow your speaker to be heard better. And if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and I'll be trying to do a video every week. Thank you for your time.